Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante is brought to you by Tobacco Free Florida.
Kick it. From our Magic Studios in Orlando, Florida, this is Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante.
And welcome, everyone, to the set of Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante. I'm Dante. This is Galante. And, of course, the man down there on the end is Tony Battie, better known as Batman. Huh?
Yep. Thanks for having me,
Do people still call you that or no?
Every now and then. Not too much.
Okay.
Does the music follow you around wherever you go?
It seems to. A little bit here and there.
I would have that on my ringtone, on my phone, and everything. I'd have that everywhere.
I had to check with Warner Brothers on that one, so, you know.
All right. We might have copyright infringements all of a sudden.
Well, thanks for coming on the set. We had to wait about 10 or 11 weeks. We had to work out the kinks before we brought you in, but we're glad to have you here on the studio.
Oh, is that what it was?
That's what it was. We just wanted to make sure we knew what we were doing first.
I thought maybe you guys had some inside information and
you know,
didn't tell me. Maybe I was on the trading block maybe me stuff and the janitor had to draw straws who would come on next.
The janitor wasn't available, and stuff doesn't talk.
Yeah, okay.
Neither was Gerald Sasser. We did put in a call to him. We tried to get him on here, but he couldn't make it. All right, well, Tony, take a look at the monitor. You may know this guy is Justin McKim, but we call him Mad Dog. Mad Dog, what's going on?
Hey, guys, as you can see, I'm a barista now at Starbucks. You know, it's a Valentine's weekend, and I had to make a little extra cash. You know, Mrs. Mad Dog, she loves her jewelry. So what would you guys like today? A pumpkin spice cream, or I even have a peppermint mocha twist just for you guys.
I think you can keep both of those.
Yeah. Both of them. They're excellent.
Keep I'm going to pass.
Yeah, a little part-time job. Hey, you got to do what you got to do. Mrs. Mad Dog apparently needs the...
She needs the jewelry,
needs
guys.
Needs the jewelry. All right, well, let's transition now into Tony Battie as a player. Oh, yeah, a little keeping with the Batman theme. Tony, talk about your days at Texas Tech. And this is one of the – we had a conversation about this before. And some of the records that you hold there at that school and in that conference, and they were kind of astounding. And you reported back to us. You said, hey, I wasn't always just a role player, right? I mean, that's – just talk about some of your days back.
You know, I was more of the big gun back then, myself and another teammate of mine, Corey Carr. So, you know, I got more shots back then than I do now, you know, and I was – I was more focal point of the offense than I am now, but roles change, and you know.
You're being too modest. You can say you were the man.
Yeah, you can say it.
I walk around here saying I'm the man all the time. Nobody gives me any grief.
I mean, well, you guys, you know the transition from a backroom studio and radio to in front of the camera. I mean,
it's scary, isn't it?
It is. It is.
Well, talk about your transition. So you go. I mean, being dominant, being a dominant part of the offense and what have you, and then. To transition into the NBA, how was that for you?
I mean, it was what basketball is all about. You get to play with the best players in the game, and then you learn a different system. Of course, going from college to NBA is a different type of game. So it was a challenge, but it was something I was up for and looking forward to.
Now you've carved out quite a niche. I mean, you've done pretty well for yourself doing, if you want to call it a role. I don't even know, is that what you even want to refer to it as?
Yeah, I mean, I'm a blue-collar player now. Mm-hmm. I'm more of a role player. I'm the Robin to the Superman, so to speak.
Yeah,
that's
right.
You know, I know my role, and I like to play it well.
Now we're done talking basketball. That's it. We wanted to get everyone caught up today. Then you actually have played with LeBron, Dwight Howard, and Paul Pierce. So it is a pretty impressive resume. You've got to play with a lot of superstars in this league, haven't you?
Yeah, I have. You know, I credit some of their success to me.
Naturally.
You know,
as you should.
I won't be modest about it. But, no, I had the pleasure of playing alongside some great players and Antoine Walker and all those guys. So, you know, I'm going to have this Fab Five of all-star players that I've probably played against. So I'm getting that list together right now.
I'm just glad you got out of there before they picked up Scalabrine.
Yeah,
that would have been uncomfortable.
Good move for you.
All right, we're done basketball. We wanted to know who is Tony Battie, and we can take a stab at it, but the viewers don't want to hear from us. They want to hear from your teammates. So we caught up with some of your teammates, Tony. Take a look at the monitor. Who is Tony Battie? Let's roll the footage.
Tony is like one of those people, you know, he will go in and he will be starting a whole lot of stuff. And then he comes out unscathed, like he had no idea what just happened. You know, he's always there stoking the fire in the plane. And then all of a sudden, you know, he's like looking the other way like, I have no idea what you're talking about. Me, I have nothing to do with this.
Tone is a quiet dude, but, you know, pretty witty. He's very witty as far as jokes and backstabbing. He's a very good backstabbing joker on the team. He's the best.
Always smiling. He's goofy. He loves doing jokes. other than that, you know, he's always somebody we can always talk to. He's like our big older brother because he's like one of the oldest guys on the team.
Tony's a great guy. He's one of the guys I look up to as a coming from being a veteran. He's a veteran player, and I look up to him. He gives me a lot of input and insight on the game, and, you know, he does a lot of things for me in terms of just being there for me when I need him.
Some nice comments, but I did hear backstabber in there. Is that? I don't think that's fair.
I got that I'm an old backstabber out of that those clips. I guess, you know, I think what they mean by that, I'll start a joke and say, oh, you know, he said this about you. Now, what do you got to say? You know, and right. Then I'll back out and just let the jokes fly, and I duck every one of them and just join in on the laugh. So that's what they mean. You know, I just try to have a great time with the fellas.
All right, well, you've been here a long time now. This is your fifth season with us, I think, or sixth?
Fifth.
Okay. Yep. And we've had a lot of giveaways and promotions over the years, okay? And we were going back and look at some of the giveaways,
yep.
And I have a bunch of them here. And okay. I can't find, and you can maybe help me, I can't find a Tony Battie one anywhere. You've been here. This is your fifth season now. I can't find one, but I have a box full of them here.
We do have some others.
Uh-oh, I'm scared now.
These are some of the things that our marketing department thought were better than giving away a Tony Battie giveaway. Okay, here's a Carlos Arroyo bobblehead.
Remember right, that right one? There.
You
remember,
that one. Of course, may have been Latin night. You know, right, you got to respect that. Carlos was okay. A fan
Rashard
favorite.
Rashard Lewis, of course. We know right. Who Rashard is, so he's right. Going to get one, I guess.
Sweet Lou.
You got the Jameer Nelson. I guess this is an action figure.
Right.
Right. I don't even know what that is, but that's an action right. figure. That's
a little bigger than Jameer, isn't
okay.
it?
Okay, you got the Hedo Turkoglu glue stick.
Oh my God! If I can't beat that one, then I mean, this is.
Oh, come
worse.
On! Did you guys kill him for that or what? That's a glue stick, wow. For God's sake.
We may have to bring this one out of the archives. And
what about this one? This was last week. The stuffed toothbrush dispenser.
You know what? I got my daughter one of these too, and she loved it. But I don't think it hung around the bathroom too long. I don't know what happened.
This
to
guy
him.
Was here 3 days, and he got a fly swatter. Darko Milicic fly swatter. How did that happen?
I mean, I guess I'm just one of those guys who flies under the radar.
All right, well, we decided you're not going to fly under the radar anymore. All right, we got some of your own giveaways. All right, here's the Tony Battie bat. We're going to give this away next week.
Right, don't we?
I'll
right?
take it.
What do you think about that?
Yeah, right? You know, as long as it's not corked and...
it's legal. No steroids legal. Needed for
yeah,
this one.
We'll take that one.
No Louisville steroids. Slugger we'll and everything. One. In okay. fact, take a look at the monitor. In fact, we got an idea for a bat hat. Do we have that? Right? Perfect.
You'd wear that right to the beach or something?
10,000 of those?
Not.
All the fans out there wearing the bat hat?
That won't get it.
All right, well, what about the T-shirt? Everybody was excited about the T-shirt, especially our sponsors.
Yeah.
They were all excited about the T-shirt.
Okay.
Come on.
Whoever the marketing director is... See me.
You're not liking that?
Nah, I think that calls for some head to roll.
But look at, if you look at the right, every single sponsor wanted on board with this. They wanted on board with the Battie shirt.
Well, I know. You're upset because you can't see your face.
Maybe that's it.
Is that what it is?
Maybe that's it.
But look at that left arm. Was that doctored in any way? Is that left arm that big?
That's all natural. That's, you know, 100% DA beef right there. That's, that's all muscle.
Wow, that's pretty impressive.
You didn't have to flex the whole time when you were doing the shot, though.
Actually, I'm not flexing. It's just... Natural.
It's called a muscle, George. You wouldn't know anything about that.
Sorry about that. Yeah, that's true.
All right, so you don't like any of our ideas?
Nah, tell the sponsors they can come at me on another angle, but not this one.
Okay.
All right. Well, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we got a lot more with Tony Battie, but we want to remind everyone, go to magicovertime.com. We're giving away tickets to the Magic Pistons game on February 27th. And the only way you can win them, go to magicovertime.com or text 57375. Keyword overtime. We're going to reveal the winner again on
MagicOvertime.com. Yeah, that's the only place you can see it.
See, nobody goes to that site, so we're hitting it as many times as we can. MagicOvertime.com.
Plug it in.
Mad Dog, what's coming up next?
Well, guys, when we come back, Tony Battie will be put to the test with this week's Would You Rather question, and what did Hedo just say? And Overtime fans, we invite you to stay connected with the Magic everywhere you go by signing up for the Orlando Magic's Magic Tech service brought to you by T-Mobile. As a Magic Tech subscriber, you'll get the latest news, scores, updates, and other insider information delivered directly to your phone. And you'll also receive breaking team news, exclusive ticket offers, retail discounts, and a whole lot more. To sign up, text the word FANTASTIC to 57375 today. We'll be back in a moment.
Magic Overtime with Dante and Galante is brought to you by Tobacco Free Florida.